Justice Dipak Misra was sworn in as the 45th Chief Justice of India today. He was administered the oath of office by President Ramnath Kovind at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Ashmit joins us now with more. Ashmit, tell us a little bit more about the new Chief Justice.
Well, Justice Dipak Misra begins his innings at the chief as the Supreme Court as the next Chief Justice of India after Justice Kher. He's here for a good 13 months. That's in relative terms at least a longer tenure. He'll be here for 13-month period. He's due to retire in October of 2018. And just to give you a brief background as to the genesis of this judge that we know today as Justice Misra. Well, he began his journey in 1996. He was appointed as an additional judge in the Odisha High Court. Subsequently, he was also the Chief Justice of the Patna High Court as well as the Delhi High Court. And then finally, in 2011, we saw Justice Misra being elevated to the apex court. Now, moving ahead, looking at some of the big landmarks in terms of the decisions that he's made. Well, one decision that will stand out has been the death sentence to Yaqub Memon. Mind you, that is one of the reasons why he now has a Z-plus security. And that is the verdict which he gave, in fact, at 3 a.m. in the morning. The next key landmark has been the death sentence that he gave to rapists in the Nirbhaya case. I was there in the Supreme Court. There was a spontaneous outburst of applause as well as cheers. That's the second key decision. The third one is when we go to the movie theaters, we have to stand up for the National Anthem. Well, you can thank Justice Misra for that. He made singing of the National Anthem compulsory in movie theaters. But that's the journey. That's the landmarks that we've seen so far. What are the landmarks or what other big decisions can we expect? Let's take a look at the cases that he's hearing. First up, the Babri Masjid case, something that has, in fact, dogged Indian politics for the last 20-odd years. Babri Masjid is one key case that he'll be adjudicating over. Sahara versus Sebi, that's been a long-drawn battle. It's now in the courtroom of Justice Misra. He will be the one responsible to seek the funds out of Subrata Roy Sahara. Aadhaar case, the big Aadhaar juggernaut that the government is currently rolling out. Whether or not it will face any stumbling blocks, well, Justice Misra will answer that. He will be hearing the Aadhaar case. The WhatsApp privacy policy case, where the privacy policy of WhatsApp has been challenged, that too is before Justice Misra. He will be deciding on that. Also, the beef ban notification, that's another key matter that does arouse a lot of sentiments. That too is, in fact, being heard by Justice Misra. But speaking of Justice Misra, well, there is an observation, there is an understanding about him that he does, is in fact, very familiar with the work of Shakespeare. He cites Shakespeare with equal ease as he does citations from the books of Hindu mythology. He's also known to be a little verbose. In fact, here's an excerpt from the judgment where he made the National Anthem mandatory. He goes on to write as a part of that judgment, and I quote here, that the National Anthem is pivotal and centripodal to the basic conception of sovereignty and integrity of India. It is the marrow of nationalism. He goes on to say that it is the hypostasis of patriotism, nucleus of national heritage, substratum of culture, and epitome of national honor. So clearly, the new Chief Justice of India, not at a loss of words. And that, of course, is your new Chief Justice, the Chief Justice of India, Justice Dipak Misra.